Marines of the Space Wolves chapter fight together in close-knit packs, all of which display their own unique pack markings on their shoulder pads. In this video, we're going to show you exactly how to paint those pack markings onto your Space Wolf miniatures. It's not as difficult as it seems. Now, the first thing you need to know is there's five different types of Space Wolf pack markings. Those for battle line, close support, fire support, HQ veterans, and of course scouts. And all of them display their own unique colour schemes. In this video, we're going to show you exactly how to paint the pack markings of a battle line unit, so perfect for Grey Hunters or Intercessors. And we'll be using this shoulder pad, which we've already undercoated here with Mechanicus Standard Grey and fully painted the armour on. Now, we're painting a battle line pack marking here, which is going to be red and black. We're going to start off with a base coat of Mephiston Red all over the shoulder pad, as painting black paint over red will be a lot easier than trying to paint red paint over black. So let's grab that Mephiston Red and our small airbrush. Let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Now here we're going to thin it down quite a bit, as you want a nice smooth coat of paint on this shoulder pad. There we go, perfect. Onto the shoulder pad, here we go, a nice even coat of Mephiston Red all over the central part of the shoulder pad here. Being super careful, of course, to make sure we're not hitting the armour we've already painted. You'll notice as it's going on quite thin. That's absolutely fine. Just make sure let the first one dry, then add a second coat over the top to get a nice solid colour. There we go, that's a nice solid coat of Mephiston Red on our shoulder pad. Okay, so let's paint in those pack markings. We're going to start off by drawing a series of lines on our shoulder pad with Black Templar contrast paint. We'll fill in the shapes we've created with a Baden Black, and then we'll cut back in with Mephiston Red to tidy it up again. First of all, it's time for that Black Templar. Grab your small airbrush for this one. Let's grab some paint from the pot like so, and take a tiny amount of paint like this, just a little bit on the end of our small airbrush. Then, onto our shoulder pad. Here, what we're going to be doing first of all is finding the centre of the shoulder pad and drawing a nice straight line from the bottom to the top, like so. All the way from the bottom right up to the top, like this, roughly in the centre. Then we're going to find a point that's about halfway between this line and the edge of the shoulder pad and just put a dot, like so, about here. We'll do the same on this side of the shoulder pad over here. Then we'll draw lines from those dots up to the centre we've just drawn at the top, like this. Hold your breath here and take your time and make sure it goes all the way to the top, like this. Same on this side. Some more paint. Once again from the bottom all the way to the top, a nice straight line that meets at the top, like so. There we go. Okay, that's the first few lines in. Let's get a few more, bit more paint on the brush then. Bit more Black Templar here, like so. Again, tiny amount of paint on the brush. Then back to our shoulder pad. So what we're looking to do here is draw a line from the bottom where this line meets the rim up to the side on the right-hand side of the shoulder pad, like this, creating a sort of V shape. There we go, perfect. Then the same on the left-hand side here, mirroring what we've just done on the right. Drawing a line up here to the pad on the left-hand side, making sure the line meets the pad at the same height. With those lines in place, let's fill in our shapes with a Baden Black. So here's taking our time to make sure just going in between the lines we've already painted, being as neat as we can. Now we'll go back with our original colour, in this case Mephiston Red, to cut back into this design to help straighten lines, even spaces out, and to make it as neat as we possibly can. So there we go, that's our pack marking painted on. But one more thing on the shoulder pad, let's shade around the recesses now to help blend it all together. Let's grab some Basilicanum Grey and our small airbrush. Let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Just a tiny amount here, not too much needed here at all. And what we're going to be doing on our shoulder pad here is just very carefully painting this Basilicanum Grey into the recesses around the edges of the shoulder pad where it meets the armour. So just a nice even shade like this around the edges, just being super careful. That will really help blend those pack markings in. There we go, that's our battle line pack marking done. Now you can use this method of drawing lines and filling in the shapes and being as neat as possible to create just about any shape you like. Let's have a look at the colours of the other pack markings. Here we have a close support pack marking. Here we started with Avalon Sunset as a base coat, then used red contrast paint and Mephiston Red over the top to fill in that shape. For the fire support markings, we started with Korax white as a base coat and then painted black over the top. For the HQ and veterans, we started with Avalon Sunset and then used black over the top. And for the scouts, we painted the black markings straight over the normal Space Wolf colours. So there we go. That's how you can paint pat markings onto your Space Wolf miniatures. I hope you found the video interesting. Happy painting.